Dear students, today we learn about the practicals of the DC machine. Now, our aim is to study magnetization characteristics of DC shunt generator. Now, this is our aim for the practicals. Circuit diagram. This is a motor set which is connected to the generator set. Now the DC generator shaft is coupled with the DC motor. So first of all, this is a LFA. This is nothing but the. This is a 3-point starter. L is nothing but the line. This is a F, which is called a field, and this is a that is called a armature. And L is nothing but the line. Now, how to make the connection? For the line, a positive of the mains. This is a positive from the supply. As we use the DC supply for the DC motor, so we use the 220 volt DC supply. So positive of the mains is directly connected to the L. So this is nothing but the positive is connected to the L. That is line of the 3-point starter. This is called this 3-point LFA is called a 3-point starter. So positive of the mains is connected to the line, then F is nothing but the field point of a 3-point starter. For the F, we connect here rheostat, and rheostat is connected to the field winding. And the second of the field winding means the ZZ of the field winding is connected to the negative. Then third point of the starter is armature. Now armature of the starter is connected to the armature, that is positive armature of the motor and the negative armature of the motor, and which is connected, these all are connected to the negative of the supply. Then the motor shaft is coupled with the generator shaft. Now in the generator we have to find the magnetization characteristics of DC shunt generator. So magnetization characteristics of the generator is also called as OCC, is also called as OCC, that is nothing but the open circuit characteristics of the DC generator. So DC generator is connected with the field winding. Here the field winding is connected in the parallel to the generator. Here no need to insert a rheostat in our experiment. And to measure the value of the voltage induced in the generator, so here we use the voltmeter. So voltmeter is connected parallel to the generator. To measure the field current, ammeter is connected in series with the field winding. So this is nothing but the arrangement to find the magnetization characteristics of the DC generator. Now why we use here DC motor? Because we know that in power plant, to give the rotation to the generator, we have to use the turbine. Now but in our lab there is no existence of the turbine. So instead of turbine, we to give the mechanical input to the generator, we use the motor. So we know motor having electrical input and mechanical output. So that mechanical output of the motor is given to the input for the generator. So this is nothing but the arrangement of a magnetization curve or OCC. Now in the theory part, we already we already discussed in details about the OC series, open circuit characteristics of the decision generator. We just revise the things here. OCC is nothing but duck curve in between E0, that is no load voltage, is the curve in between E0, no load voltage, and IF, that is field current. Now we know that the voltage buildup, we already learned in the theory lecture that voltage buildup in a generator, initially a residual flux is present in the field winding. When the armature of the generator rotates, it cut that residual flux, and EMF is induced. Means when there is a when there is a zero value of the field current, at that time there is a small value of EMF induced, and that is called a residual EMF. So this curve will start from this value because of the residual flux, and after that point, when we increase the value of the field current, here the status is there are some values of the field current, and this is the values of the voltage buildup. Now as the field current goes on increases, E0 also goes on increases, so we get the curve in this way, and this is called a OCC, open circuit characteristics, or we say that magnetization characteristics or no load saturation curve. So this is a theoretical part. Now we have to learn how practically we get this curve. So for that, we have to use virtual labs for the practical analysis of this circuit. So remember this circuit, remember this connection, that positive is connected to L, then P up is connected to rheostat and through field, and A is connected to armature. Then here generator's armature, this is nothing but the generator armature, is connected to field winding through ammeter and then voltmeter. So here we will switch for the analysis to the virtual lab. So go to virtual lab. Now here to open the browser, here now I search electrical machine, electrical machine one virtual lab. So here we get the link at www.vlab.co.in. open that link. Now here we get electrical machine lab new in IIT Roorkee. So open this. Now here list of experiments are given. In this, experiment number 7 is to study magnetization characteristics of DC shunt generator. So we open this. Now this is our aim, to study magnetization characteristics of DC shunt generator and draw the graph between armature voltage and field current. Now theory, we already know about the theory, we already discussed in the theory part, so we will not discuss here. Now procedure. So in the procedure, the connections are given, that MCB is connect negative to the rheostat 1, connect MCB negative to the motor A2. So this is nothing, these are the procedures we have to follow for the connections. Then in the next step, we open the simulation. But actually simulations operation here. In this, now here we get the, our set and we have to connect it and get the proper output. Now here we have to make the connections of the circuit. Now first of all, these are the LFA, line, armature and field, that is a 3-point starter. This is the MCB, that is positive negative DC supply. Voltmeter 1 is given, ammeter 1 is given. Then rheostat is given and this is a motor generator set. Now in the MCB, as we use the DC supply, so there are two terminals are given, positive and negative. For the starter, 3 points are given and we use the 3-point starter, that is L, A and F, that is line, armature and field. Voltmeter is given, ammeter is given. Then rheostat having again two terminals are given, entering and outgoing terminal. Now here the motor shaft is connected to the generator shaft and here we have given an observation table. Now we know from the connection, as we discussed the connection on the slide, similar, we know positive of the this mains is connected to the line. So here we connect the positive to the line first. Then from the field, then second point is nothing but the field. From the field, yep, we connect the field to the rheostat here. Now the second part of the rheostat here, rheostat is connected to the field of the motor. So this point, these are the F1 and F2 point, that is field point. This is a A1 and A2 point, that is armature point. So here from 2, it is connected to the field. And F2, that is a second part of the field, F2 is connected to the negative. They're from the previous diagram, that is as we discussed from the slide, that field is connected to the negative of the MCB. Then A of the, again, this rheostat. From the rheostat, just wait, we have to reset this connection. First of all, we connect the positive to the L, then yup, from the field is connected to the this second point, the entering point, then from first, we have to connect this to the field. Means here, from field point, we connect first rheostat and then rheostat is connected to field. And the second part of the field is connected. The second part of the field is connected to the negative of the MCB. Also, we have to connect this point 1 to the negative of the MCB. So here we connect negative to the MCB. Then starter A, that is armature. So armature part is connected to the positive of the armature here. And A2 of the armature is again connected to the negative of the MCB. So these are the connections of the motor. Now in the generator side, we have to add voltmeter in parallel with the armature. So A3 of the armature is connected to the voltmeter 1, and voltmeter, that is first point of the voltmeter, and here second point of the voltmeter is connected to the A4. Means in general, a voltmeter is connected in parallel with the armature of the DC generator. Then a field wind, to measure the value of the field current, a ammeter is connected. Now ammeter is connected to this in series with the field. So here we connect the ammeter. Now whether our connections are correct or not, so we have to check it. So this is a check option. From that, it is a check that whether our connection is right or wrong. So here we click on the check. So correct connection, the message is correct connection. If you make any wrong connection, then the message show that it is a wrong connection. So our connections are correct. Now we have to make the motor on. So here MCB is up. To on, to make it on, we have to click it. So here if you click, now our MCB is on, our LF starter is on, and our generator is rotating. Now we have to take a reading, various readings. That now this our rheostat pointer is at the maximum position. So whenever we move it, let us say this reading, means whenever the field current increases to 0.16, initially there is no field current. Okay, at this position. Now means when the field here, as the field current increases, means here we goes on decreasing the value of field resistance. As the field resistance decreases, field current increases. So when for this value of the field current increases, our voltage is also increases. Now we have to add this reading in the observation table. So here we add this reading. Again we vary the rheostat for this. Now again we add this, add to table. Now we have to take up to 6 reading to plot the graph. Now again we increase the value to, that is 0.2 field current. Then the 126 is the voltage. 0.21 is 133. So these are the readings. We have take the various reading for the various, that is for the various field current. Here our field current 0.16, 0.18, 0.2, 0.21, 22, 23. We may increase it, means for the 0.24. For the 0.24, it is 135. So these are the various reading. Now if you this is our observation table. Now if you want to plot the graph between voltage and current, click on the plot graph, and here we get a graph. Now we can see that as the, this is the current is taken, in this current is taken on the y-axis and voltage is taken on the x-axis. from this we see that as the current goes on increases, voltage is also increases. So this is nothing but the OCC of a DC machine. Here we see that this curve will not start from the origin. It will start from the some value that it is due to residual flux, and this EMF, which when the field current is zero until we get the some value of the EMF, and that is EMF is called residual EMF. So this is about the practical, today's practical is magnetization curve of a DC machine.